and shattering of all the solid things. His home, his life, all the solid things. Divorce, a breaking word, an ugly breaking word. Divorce, secrets. No, not secrets, so much as just the secret. What he knew and had not told anybody. What he knew about his mother. Of the plane came obviously in some discomfort, must have stomach troubles. So, this summer, the first summer when he was allowed to have visitation rights with his father, with the divorce only 1 month old, Brian was heading north. His father was a mechanical engineer who had designed or invented a new drill bit for oil drilling, a self-cleaning, self-sharpening bit. He was working in the oil fields of Canada, up on the tree line where the tundra started and the forest ended. Brian was riding up from New York with some drilling equipment. It was lashed down in the rear of the plane next to a fabric bag the pilot had called her survival pack, which had emergency supplies in case they had to make an emergency landing that had to be specially made in the city. Riding in the bush plane with the pilot named Jim or Jake or something who had turned out to be an alright guy, letting him fly and all. Except for the smell. Now there was a constant odor, and Brian took another look at the pilot, found him rubbing the shoulder and down the arm now, the left arm, letting go more gas and wincing. Probably something he ate, Brian thought. His mother had driven him from the city to meet the plane at Hampton where it came to pick up the drilling equipment. A drive in silence, a long drive in silence. 2.5 hours of sitting in the car, staring out the window, just as he was now staring out the window of the plane. Once, after an hour, when they were out of the city, she turned to him. Look, can't we talk this over? Can't we talk this out? Can't you tell me what's bothering you? And there were the words again. Divorce. Split. The secret. How could he tell her what he knew? So he had remained silent, shook his head, and continued to stare unseeing at the countryside. And his mother had gone back to driving, only to speak to him one more time when they were close to him. She reached over the back of the seat and brought up a paper sack. I got something for you, for the trip. Brian took the sack and opened the top. Inside there was a hatchet, the kind with a steel handle and a rubber hand grip. The head was in a stout leather case that had a brass riveted belt loop. It goes on your belt, his mother spoke